This week, I'm talking about how a supernova exploded near Earth 2 to 3 million years ago, covering all of us in its guts. Supernovas are massive stars that at the end of their life, they burn out and collapse under their own weight until they reach the point that they can't take it anymore, and then they explode out violently in the form of mixed up stuff. But these violent explosions are just so violent that scientists have dubbed anything within a 32 light year radius of a supernova to be living within a kill zone. But these violent ends have violent delights. They're among the most beautiful objects to look at within the universe. And they are also the main cosmic source of any element heavier than helium. What's amazing is that we've found evidence for a supernova that exploded near the Earth. Thankfully, not within the 32 light year kill zone, so any Earthlings at the time weren't immediately killed off by this supernova, but instead this supernova sprinkled stardust over us for a few millennia, kind of like glitter at a rave party. This glitter was actually radioactive cosmic dust. The nuclear reactions that take place inside of a supernova can create radioactive iron, a variation of iron that has more neutrons in it. This specific variation of iron actually is called iron-60 and has a half-life of 2.6 million years. Because we know iron-60 can only stick around for so long before it disappears, we can trace any iron-60 that we find on Earth to being attributed to relatively recent supernovas. It's kind of like a timestamp for a dying star. What's so cool is that scientists have recently discovered iron-60 under the sea, on the moon, and within the fossils of once living organisms. Under the sea exists ferromanganese crusts, and these are rocks that essentially have little iron and manganese collections. They scoop up little pieces of metal that float by in the ocean. These crusts grow very slowly, maybe only 1 millimeter per every million years or so, but they sort of act like tree rings in the ocean. What's exciting is that researchers, when they looked into them, actually found radioactivity in them, attributed to iron-60 and correlated with the timeline of 2 to 3 million years ago. Even more fascinating is that when they checked different locations around the Earth, they found different distribution amounts of iron-60, suggesting perhaps they could find clues of what direction the supernova explosion hit us from. This led researchers to look for iron-60 and samples of moon rock that came back from the Apollo missions. The moon, unlike Earth, doesn't have an atmosphere or wind, so it can more accurately archive things and more accurately show the direction that things hit it from. Sure enough, when the researchers looked into this moon dirt, they were able to discover 2 to 3 million year old iron-60 present in it as well. But an even cooler piece of evidence comes from magnetotactic bacteria, which are these little microorganisms that orient and migrate along magnetic field lines. These little weirdos live in sediment and love to chow down on iron, which they then synthesize into magnetic crystals. As the bacteria die off over time, these nanocrystals eventually become known as magnetofossils. It's so awesome to think about using biology, geology, and lunar science as sort of a telescope for looking at supernovas. There's even some speculation that the cosmic rays from this supernova affected Earth's climate enough to affect the migration patterns of our human ancestors. There's a lot of really weird and awesome things to be discovering, and actually astrophysicist Brian Fields dubs this all the era of supernova archaeology, where we can use all of these multidisciplinary sciences to be able to learn more about supernovas and how supernovas affect the Earth. That's it for me this week, space friends. Remember to become an official space friend by joining my Patreon and supporting me creating more geeky, awesome videos like this one.